Covaxin is yet to be included in the WHO COVID-19 vaccine emergency use listing, and the Global Health Agency has cited reasons for it. Ever since the announcement about Covaxin's data submission by Bharat Biotech for the approval from WHO, reports have been emerging predicting the date for the final decision on the Indian COVID-19 vaccine. According to the WHO's chief scientist, Soumya Swaminathan, the agency's technical advisory group will meet on 26th October to consider granting the emergency use listing to the vaccine. Many Indian people are keeping an eye on it because of their travel plans, which are dependent on WHO's EUL for the vaccine. Many young people who have taken Covaxin and want to study abroad are hoping for approval from the UN agency, as many of the nations have declared that they'll recognize vaccines approved by the global health body, despite the fact that various public health organizations have already spoken out against the requirement of vaccination as a condition of travel. The practice continues in numerous nations, including in Europe. A few days back, the World Health Organization had put out a tweet saying that it understands that many people are waiting for its recommendation on whether Covaxin should be added to the emergency use listing, but it cannot rush it, adding that it needs more evidence from Bharat Biotech. WHO had previously stated that Bharat Biotech has been supplying data to them on a rolling basis and that fresh material was submitted on the 27th of September after the Global Health Authority requested for further information. A scientist who has counseled companies on how to submit the applications for WHO vaccine pre-qualification said, "The WHO has a process and it has technical reports specific to each class of vaccines and requirement from the specific companies. The pre-qualification team also gives clear guidance on what is expected from all these companies. And after that, there are clinical data requirements. Unless all these companies submit these data together to scientific advisory group of experts, they cannot decide whether to grant the emergency use listing or not." The person also said that if the data is insufficient, the approval doesn't go through. And this has already happened with Covaxin after the Brazilian authority declined to give a green signal to the Bharat Biotech's jab Covaxin, which was due to lack of data. However, the World Health Organization in a Twitter thread said that it is awaiting one additional piece of information from Bharat Biotech before deciding whether or not to award the emergency use listing. In case of the Bharat Biotech, the problem is not that the company is unfamiliar with all these procedures. It has previously received pre-qualification for various other vaccinations, such as those for typhoid and also the rotavirus. Those vaccines were developed on a different platform than Covaxin, which is developed using whole variant inactivated viral cell derived platform technology. Though Covaxin was licensed by the Indian regulators in the month of January this year, when the company began the phase 2 studies, WHO requires evidence from the phase 3 trial, and Bharat Biotech's phase 3 data was released in July. However, WHO's technical committee takes anywhere from 3 to 5 months to make a EUL decision, considering several factors. The UN agency said in a Twitter thread that the time frame for EUL method is determined by how soon a firm making the vaccine can deliver the data needed for the World Health Organization to evaluate the vaccine's safety, quality, suitability for low and middle income nations, and efficacy. A senior official at Bharat Biotech told on the 18th of October that the World Health Organization was following a standard review process and the company was sharing all the information that was being requested by the body. Meanwhile, WHO's chief scientist, Soumya Swaminathan, said in a tweet that the technical advisory group will meet on 26th October to consider EUL for Covaxin. WHO has been working closely with Bharat Biotech to complete the dossier. WHO's goal is to have a broad portfolio of vaccines approved for emergency use and to expand the access to populations everywhere across the world.